Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. This video is a review of the various common reducing agents that students encounter during a typical two-semester sequence of Organic Chemistry 1 and Organic Chemistry 2. The list covered in this video is not comprehensive, but it should cover most reductions in most courses. Of course, your instructor may include additional reactions that are not discussed in this video. If I left out one of your favorite reductions, please let me know in the comments section. If I get multiple suggestions, I'll make a follow-up video. Before we start showing a bunch of reactions, let's go over some overarching ideas. First, we will emphasize reductions of carbon atoms in this video. Organic chemists spend most of their time worrying about carbon atoms. Second, one common way to recognize a reduction reaction involves the addition of a new hydrogen atom to a carbon. Third, another common way to recognize a reduction reaction is to lose a bond to an electronegative atom, such as oxygen or a halogen. So, as we go through these reactions, if you are questioning whether the reaction is truly a reduction, look for either the addition of a hydrogen atom or loss of a carbon electronegative atom bond. Let's now see some common reduction reactions. First, let's discuss hydrogenation reactions. In intro organic classes, hydrogenations normally involve hydrogen, H2 gas, and a palladium catalyst on carbon, PDC. This reagent combination is excellent for adding hydrogen across a carbon-carbon pi bond, whether it is an alkene or an alkyne. Both functional groups are reduced all the way down to an alkane. In the top reaction, we can see that the two added hydrogens both end up on the same face, shown as the top face with both hydrogens up, to show that the hydrogenation is a syn addition. In the lower hydrogenation of the alkyne, we see that multiple equivalents of hydrogen can be added. In fact, in general, you do not need to specify that you have two equivalents of hydrogen for this reaction. It is understood that you have as much hydrogen as you want and will keep adding hydrogen until you run out of C-C pi bonds. Note that the C-C pi bonds in the aromatic rings do not participate in the hydrogenation. These two hydrogenations are the standard reactions. Here are two more to the right. The top reaction is a hydrogenation of an alkyne with hydrogen, palladium on carbon, as well as barium sulfate and quinoline. These last two reagents poison the catalyst and cause the second addition to be slow enough to stop the reaction at the alkene. This reagent system is called Lindler's catalyst. The addition is still a syn addition, and you can see that in the Z configuration of the alkene product with both hydrogens on the same side. The lower reaction is the same, except it uses a different catalyst, in this case a nickel boride catalyst. Again, it's a syn addition. Other metals can be used in hydrogenations, but palladium or platinum is the most common one shown in college organic chemistry. Really similar to a hydrogenation is a hydrogenolysis. Hydrogenolysis is the cutting, lysis, of a bond with hydrogen. The most common example is the cleavage of a benzyl group, a CH2 phenyl group, from an oxygen or nitrogen. The reaction requires a palladium catalyst. This reaction may not seem like a reduction. In the top reaction, you would most likely be interested in the left side of the molecule. After the reaction, you'd be interested in the alcohol. The other product, this is toluene, would be waste. Where is the reduction? Well, from the perspective of the side carbon of toluene, we've gone from having two hydrogens in the starter material to three hydrogens in the product. That carbon lost a CO bond and gained a CH bond. This is indeed a carbon reduction. The reaction also works to remove benzyl groups from nitrogen atoms. The metal hydrides are very common reducing agents, maybe the most common ones used in organic chemistry classes. While there are literally dozens of metal hydrides, the frequent hitters are sodium borohydride and lithium aluminum hydride, sometimes called LAH. These reagents are best for reducing CO and CN pi bonds. When it comes to aldehydes and ketones, the simple carbonyl compounds, both sodium borohydride and lithium aluminum hydride, can convert the carbonyl to an alcohol through the addition of hydrogen, first as a hydride from the reagent and second as a proton, either from ethanol or water. That's how ketones and aldehydes behave. Once you consider acid derivative carbonyls, like esters and amides, you normally need to use lithium aluminum hydride to reduce the carbonyl. Note that the acid derivatives behave a little differently from one another. With esters, the carbonyl oxygen remains in the product and forms an alcohol. With amides, the carbonyl oxygen is completely lost and replaced with two hydrogens. In all instances, the carbonyl carbon loses bonds to electronegative atoms and gains hydrogens. These are certainly reductions. So these are carbonyl reductions. How about reductions of CN pi bonds? Reduction of CN pi bonds is often part of a reductive amination. On the top row, we have the reaction of a primary amine with a carbonyl, an aldehyde, to form an imine, the CN double bond. The imine can react with sodium borohydride, a reduction, to form a secondary amine. The bottom row shows a ketone reacting with a secondary amine. This reaction gives an enamine. Enamines can also be reduced with sodium borohydride to give an amine, a tertiary amine in this case. The reduction of the enamine to an amine looks like the CC pi bond was reduced, as if a hydrogenation. This reaction, however, most likely starts with protonation of the enamine to give an aminium ion, which then gets attacked by the hydride to form the amine product. We've now seen the most common reductions. Let's now see some of the less common ones. When you learn about reactions on aromatic rings, most students learn about the Clemmensen and Wolff-Kischner reductions. Both reductions perform the same transformation. Both completely remove the oxygen of an aromatic ketone. The Clemmensen reduction involves a zinc-mercury amalgam in acid, and the Wolff-Kischner involves hydrazine, strong base, and lots of heat. As long as the ketone is directly attached to the aromatic ring, the oxygen will be completely removed and replaced with two hydrogens. If the carbonyl is part of an ester, the reaction will not work. If the carbonyl is close, but not directly next to the aromatic ring, then the reaction will not work. The ketone must be an aromatic ketone, an aryl ketone. This bottom right compound is kind of interesting. Let's say you wanted to remove the oxygen of the ketone. It can't be done with the Clemmensen or Wolff-Kischner. Is it possible another way? Sure, we could take that ketone and reduce it to an alcohol with sodium borohydride. We could then convert the alcohol to a tosylate and do an E2 elimination with strong base the resulting alkene could then be reduced with hydrogen and palladium on carbon. We can't do this reduction in one step, like with the Clemmensen, but we can still do it through other reduction reactions. It just takes a bit more work. This slide shows a pair of reductions that are called dissolving metal reductions. These conditions, which involve sodium metal that is literally dissolved in liquid ammonia, are most commonly associated with the reduction of alkynes to alkenes, as seen on the left, or reduction of aromatic rings. Alkynes reduced under these conditions give mostly the e-alkene configuration. The aromatic ring reduction, called a Birch reduction, gives a cyclic 1,4-diene. I normally do not cover the Birch reduction in my classes, but it can be a useful reaction. It's the only reduction I'll mention in this video that involves disrupting an aromatic ring. These reactions involve pumping electrons into a pi bond in the starter material to form a carbanion. The basic carbanion gets protonated by the ammonia. This process repeats again to give the addition of two hydrogens to the molecule. Here are some more reductions that involve metals. Anytime one converts a halide into a Grignard reagent, an organomagnesium compound, or an organolithium reagent, a carbon loses a bond to a halogen and is being reduced. Most people would say, let's make a Grignard reagent, rather than let's reduce the carbon with magnesium or lithium. But these are indeed reductions. On a similar note, when organometallics add to a carbonyl, the process is a reduction as the carbon loses a CO bond. Again, most people would not often call this a reduction, but formally it is a reduction reaction. Let's see a couple other miscellaneous reactions that are carbon reductions. We just saw the Grignard reagent formation and called it a reduction. Let's see a complete transformation. We can convert the bromide to a Grignard and then react it with water. The overall transformation is from a CBr bond to a CH bond. That is a reduction. At the bottom, we see a nitro group on an aromatic ring. The nitro group can be converted to a diazonium ion, which can be replaced with hydrogen through reaction with hypophosphorus acid, H3PO2. The overall transformation is to lose a CN bond and replace it with a CH bond. Again, that is a reduction. Okay, let's finish with a couple reductions of nitrogen atoms. We can identify reductions of nitrogen just like carbon. Just look for either the breaking of NO bonds or formation of NH bonds. On top, alkyl azides, which are easy to form through SN2 reactions, can be reduced to amines. Many reagents are possible, including H2 and palladium on carbon. The bottom reaction is the reduction of an aromatic nitro group to an aniline. Again, there are very many reagents that perform this reduction. One is, again, H2 with palladium on carbon. This is a reduction. This video is not a comprehensive list of all reductions you may have encountered. Students in organic chemistry will see reductions associated with the ozonolysis reaction, the oxymercuration, the Wittig reaction, and more. If you'd like to see another video that reviews less common reduction reactions, please leave a comment about the specific reaction you would like to see. That was a quick review of common reduction reactions. Please leave a comment, leave a like, or subscribe to the channel. Take care.